Hello everyone, this is Chromý, and together we will continue the course Interdisciplinary Approaches to Language and its Use. In this brief presentation, we will conclude the series of the biological foundations of language, and we will sum up what we said until now. The main question we dealt with in the previous slides was whether the language is innate or not. From what we said, it seems that this question is actually too coarse-grained, and we cannot come up with a simple yes or no answer. Things are much more complicated, and we acquire language partially based on certain innate abilities and partially based on the input we get. Moreover, it seems that various abilities which are innate and which are necessary for language may not be language-specific at all. In other words, language may share various underlying abilities with other cognitive capacities. The discussion on language innateness may be viewed also from the perspective of an old distinction between nature versus nurture. However, this distinction seems also to be quite broad and rough. It is clear that language is a cultural phenomenon, and it would be a mistake to leave it out from our sight. However, culture cannot explain everything. Language seems to be also genetically based, and genetics may constrain it somehow. Before we will end this short presentation, I have one reading tip for you. The ideas and findings we have discussed until now are narrowly tied to our understanding of the process of the evolution of language. Unfortunately, we do not have time here to go into details on this topic. If you are interested in how language evolved and from which perspectives we may approach this fairly broad issue, you may want to read the book Language Evolution, which was edited by Morten Christiansen and Simon Kirby. That is all from me now. See you next time.